Hey boys, hey girls. Want to give a birthday shout out to Lisa in Cochran, Georgia. I think I said that right. Cochran, Georgia. Yeah. Happy birthday, Toots. She's gonna be 50 on the 16th of December. Yeah, I think I got all that right. Let's go on and just make us some hamburger steaks and gravy, which is a mom and pop diner meal down here that they serve for lunches and things like that. And it's a good belly warming comfort food, okay? So, first you gotta have some French bread. You don't have to. Make cornbread, slice bread, some onions, some garlic.
So the first thing you do is wash your damn hands, boy. I got some 80-20 grind chuck down here. And we're gonna form us some little patties for this onion mushroom gravy. So let me get some little balls formed. Put it down there, boy. And we'll make us some hamburger patties.
So a little lesson. If you word is meat too much and try to work salt inside of your grind meat by mixing it in, you're gonna come up with a meatloaf-like texture. It's not gonna be as tender. And it's gonna start to make a sausage. Salt reacts very quickly with ground meat, or any meats. And ground meat is the worst because of the way it's ground, boy. So what we're gonna do is salt them on the outside. And my pan's probably gonna only hold four at a time. So we'll salt and pepper them. But I'm not gonna do these yet. I'm gonna keep these cool in the refrigerator. I'm gonna do these first.
All right.
So rough form you some patties. Don't sit there and work them to death. Just form them. Okay. Do the same way if you're gonna grill these burgers. You don't wanna work them to death. Just leave them alone now. Put you a little bit more seasoning on the back side. And let's fry them off in a pan.
Some Earl
in a frying pan. Turn the fire on. And we don't need too much because the burgers are going to release 20% of that fat. Okay. Now you know. Now this is the only time you should mash down on your burgers. Is when you're cooking them in Earl like this. Don't do this on the grill. Or griddle unless you are working at a fast food joint. And I ain't coming to eat that. Trust me, boy. What this does is give you maximum surface contact with that pan and helps them to brown evenly as that the little straws and the muscle straws that are grind start to shrink up. They start pulling away from the bottom of the pan. Just don't keep pressing and pressing and pressing. Press them one time, leave them alone. Then we're gonna flip them. You're recording stupid. Let's go on and flip them. Mash them one time on that side. That's it.
like that, and do the rest of them. All right, first batch coming out. Got to get another batch in there. We'll keep that first batch warm in the oven. Second batch is in. Smash them down. One time. That's all the law allows down here in South Louisiana. Period. We're only doing the first minute. Don't mash them no more on that side. Mash them again on the second side, but that's it. Let's get our second batch out. And these are not fully cooked yet. We'll put them on in here with the first batch. Put them back in the oven. We got a lot of grease in there, you see that? We're gonna dump some of that grease out. And then watch it. So I'm gonna pull it off a bunch of grease. Let's put some onions in there. And they're gonna start releasing water. That's gonna help deglaze this pan. You see, that's where the gravy flavor is at. What's going to make this meal live and in person. It's Saturday night? No, it ain't. It's Tuesday. Thursday, yeah, that's it. So, let's help that deglaze a little bit. Watch here. Of course, a little bit of how you call it. In there, some dry red wine. Let's whir this around. And get all that goodness off the bottom of that pan. Oh, the damn burger's got to go back in the oven. I know. I'm going to do that in a minute. See all that releasing? Yum! And we're going to give these onions some sweat down time. Let's chunk us in some sliced mushrooms with the juice. Like that there. Yum. We're gonna put the cover on this and let this cook down for a little bit. Where the top? Come here, top. Alright, so let's make us some cream potatoes. Two. I got some of these Yukon Gold potatoes. We're going to chunk them in there and make us some cream taters with them. Just pour the whole damn bag in there, JB. Don't mess around too much. Or as many as you can fit. Yeah, that's the ticket. I can see there's too many mismatched sizes in there. So I'm gonna try to put the biggest ones and take some of these smaller ones out the way. We'll keep them for another thing. Now, they're more uniform. Somewhat. Down there, boy, pay attention.
Well, let's get these burling. I'll probably go ahead and just chunk some salt in that water for general principles. Now, Miss JB, in her infinite wisdom, wants her burgers not in the gravy. Got no idea why, but I'm sure putting my foe in there. And it saves the texture. She just hollered in the background. So we're gonna cover them with foil and try to keep them moist in the oven. Put me one more in there. I think I'll eat all of them. Now we got to get a gravy thickener in there, and that's gonna be some flour and water to thicken that up. And we're gonna taste that gravy for salt and pepper. We're gonna probably have to add some other stuff to it, like salt and pepper and Cajun seasonings. You knew that, though. Go ahead and warm up some of Alan's Italian cut green beans, or cut Italian green beans. And I'm gonna warm them up in the pot that I cooked the handle off of. Wore it out, large papa tot. Now these are good, fresh out the can. You want to put some bacon in there, or anything else you want, do that. You can eat them just like this. Look over here. Warm them up. They're good. Now them ain't got enough grease in there. As a matter of fact, they got none. Put us some butter. Butter is your friend. Taters ain't ready. Everything else coming together. You know, we ain't even put no garlics in there. We'll fix that up in a minute. Okie dokie, let's take us some flour. How much flour? Look, that down there. And that. Let's put us some Cajun seasoning in it. Some garlic, extra garlic powder. Worry that about a little bit. And some salt. Stand by while I get it. Some salt. Miss JB sounds sickly. Now we gotta put some cold water in here. And we're gonna go pour that in that meat over there. See that? How much water? No, I don't know about that much. Right there. Do use cold water. If you put hot water in here and pour it into a hot pot, what you gonna have? Watch my other videos, you'll see, boy. Now let's put some of this browning sauce in here. And yeah, the kitchen bouquet is about the same thing. This one's just got a little extra kick. Do shake the hell out of it, because all that stuff settles out in the bottom. Shake the shit out of it. Trust me. About a tablespoon. It's like magic. Voodoo. Voodoo. Maybe I ought to rename this
Video Cajun Voodoo Hamburger Steaks. Now, I may do that just for fun. The gravy gonna thicken up too. Pot hadn't returned to the burrow yet. We'll deal with that in a minute. Pan, pot, lots of papa tot. Yum. Yum. That tastes fine. So now let's go ahead and make us some mashed taters. Already put a stick of butter in there. And we need to get some salt and pepper. Pepper. Some salt. And we need to get some cream. This is evap milk. And that's what's gonna make these taste sweet and yum, boy. Let that butter. Come on, butter, do your stuff. Yum, my friend. So let me get them whipped up. There you go. Check them for salt. Yum. Them's gonna be good underneath that gravy. Oh, hell yeah. Now, let's get us some of these. Now, let's get us some of these green peas. Cook with that butter. Like that there. Them flat. Look like somebody run over with a truck, huh? Yep. I think so too. That yum is right there. Hamburger steaks with gravy. Like that. Get you another. And you know we gotta have some of them mashed taters. Go over there, spoon. See right in here. Oh, yum, boy. See a big old pile of them over there. Make you a well of the souls. Just like that. And then go and get you some of that gravy and put it in that well. Yum, my friend. Like that, Galosh Pop. What kind of bread you want? I got some Cajun French bread down here, down the bayou. Y'all get over there. Let's get that French bread fresh from the store. It was steaming in the package. They made it today. Yum, boy. Just bust you a hunk off like that right there. Gonna put it on a plate with a little piece of butter. Hey, butter. Meet Mr. French Bread. Yum, butter. We fitting to be friends, ain't we? Oh, hell yeah. There's some of that butter and inject it. Look. I know you can't see, but now you can.
Stick that butter all up in that French bread. Oh, hey, Frenchie. Hey, Mr. Frenchie. Look, I made a well. That's fine. This is fresh. It ain't warmed up. Don't need to be. If you ain't living in Louisiana, and you ain't eating right. Yum.